A fellow DoubleClutch.ca writer had the 2017 Civic Si on test this week, so I ran down and stole it for a day or two. With all the hype of the Type R floating around, I was interested to see what the good old Si was like this year. In the Si trim, you get the same engine as the model below it, but with a different compression ratio and some tuning, it makes 205 horsepower from its 1.5-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder, which is pretty much the same as the previous gen naturally aspirated Si. However, the turbo gives it a good kick of low-down torque, 192 pound-feet from 2100 RPM. You also get a helical limited slip differential in the front and some 18-inch wheels. But the question I have is, with all of the small, fast, all-wheel drive vehicles which seem to be heading the charge lately, is there still a place for light, fun, front-wheel drive cars? So while the Si is obviously very aggressively styled and is very, very red, how is it to drive?
Good. Very good, actually. I recently drove the Type R, and there's a lot of elements of that car in this one. Honda did a really good job of just making it fun to drive around at low speeds, basically. My favorite part of the car is the steering, like right off the bat. There's a really strong on-center feel, and the weight builds very well as you go into a corner. And that's not even in sport mode. In normal mode, it still feels good. There is actually feedback coming through from the road, which is so rare nowadays. It really is. There's very few cars that aren't like specially designed sports cars or supercars that actually retain steering feel like we used to back when everything was hydraulic. And then I push the sport button down here and things light up in red and it looks really exciting on the dashboard. It adds weight to the steering, stiffens up the suspension, and sharpens some stuff about the drivetrain. But you know what? Sport mode is actually quite practical for just driving around, because I wouldn't call myself an aggressive driver, but I'm definitely one who likes to be able to make a snap decision in traffic. This car responds incredibly well to that type of driving. So the steering feels fast. By fast, I mean the ratio feels quick. Whether or not it actually is quick or it's just the way that the weight comes on, I can't tell, but it feels like you add a little bit of steering lock and the car just darts into the corner. Really, really good front end grip, really crisp turn in. Okay, so we're gonna go to back roads in a second so I can feel that even better. But just on the road, like just moving around, I put my right turn signal on, a little screen comes up here, tells me there's no one in my blind spot I can see there, and I make a lane change. Like that, done, see? Very satisfying, actually. The whole car is actually quite engaging. Okay, I'm going to complain about something now, something that the other writers at DoubleClutch.ca completely disagree with me on. I'm not actually writing this car up on DoubleClutch. Adi Desai is going to be doing the written review on this one, so you can read his thoughts there, and he's going to flatly disagree with me on one point. I do not like the shifter and clutch in this car. Actually, I don't like the shifting experience at all, to be perfectly honest. So I'll agree, yes, the shifter is very snappy and positive. It clicks into gear, feels very Honda-like, but it feels kind of cheap, all right? What I mean by that is, I've isolated this. I sat there just quietly shifting back and forth, trying to figure out what it is that I don't like about the shifter. It feels like the rods that are connecting it to the transmission and like the actual turret that's selects the gears in the transmission feels like it's like pencil thin. And I have a feeling that it is, because when you select a gear, there's like this flex to it. There's like, it kind of like bounces. It feels cheap to me, actually. Yes, it's very quick, it's very positive, it's very easy to put it into gear, but it feels cheap. Now, the clutch is way too light. It is way too light. There is a feel where you can overcome the pressure plate. There's a point where you go, okay, now I'm released and now I'm engaged, which is actually uncommon. So I'll give it that, it has good feel, but it just feels like, it honestly feels like I could take the pressure plate and the transmission and go like this, whoop, 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 and just move it with my hand. There's no resistance in the clutch whatsoever. Even though it has decent feel, the lightness of it makes the car not feel sporty. Okay, so the shifter, I don't really like. The clutch, I don't really like. And the way that it changes gears, also don't really like, because there's kind of a catastrophic amount of rev hang. So shifting from first to second to third, you have to wait a long time for the revs to fall before you can select the next gear. And it's almost rivaling Subaru in the amount of rev hang it's got going on. This is how we kill the manual transmission. And I completely disagree with adding a manual for the sake of adding a manual. The manual should be one of the highlights of a car if you advertise the car with a manual transmission. Okay, so shifting out of the way, the rest of the car is very, very lovely. I actually really, really like all other aspects of this car. The interior, really well laid out. I like the look of everything in here. So the fabrics on the seat and the console here, they're kind of like a, I'm complaining again, I realize that. So the fabrics are kind of like a low thread count, I guess, right? Like a low thread count sheet. And essentially, they look like they would collect dirt very easily, right? They look kind of cool, but it reminds me of, like, you know when you go to Mark's Work Warehouse and you get a pair of, like, work pants, like, that a security guard would wear? Those, that fabric that's supposed to look dressy but is durable, that's kind of what this looks like. Not a big fan. However, from here up, everything looks great. Love the dashboard. I love this, the screen, the way the screen is integrated in the dash, very good. The center digital readout looks fantastic, and I've got a bunch of useless options here. I call them useless because you don't actually need a timer, a G readout meter, unless you're logging the data. You don't need to be able to see your G. In the middle of a corner, you shouldn't be looking at your dashboard. Anyway, there's a boost gauge and like load gauge, like a engine load. None of these are very useful. This tells me my fuel mileage though, which I am getting 7 liters per 100 kilometers in the city and the highway combined. That's really, really good for a car with 200 horsepower that's this peppy. I really, really, really like this drivetrain. Look at that, third gear, boom. Boost comes on right away. It's not like the old Honda engines you had to wait and shift frequently to keep them way up in the power band because of VTEC. The turbo gives you torque way lower down. And I actually really, really like this engine. But it still has kind of that high revving Honda sound to it. So you're not losing it because it's turbocharged. You're not losing out on the need to run it to the red line for fun, right? And I shift up sport mode, two lights flashing me there. Oh, it sounds good. I like the sound of this car. I'm not a big fan of the exhaust note they've put on it, but I like the noise coming from under the hood. Very, very cool. Now, the way this car turns in for me is one of the highlights because I really, really like front-wheel drive cars that rotate on corner entry. So cars that will corner entry oversteer, which means that as I turn into the corner, maybe under a little bit of brakes or off the throttle completely, the car will naturally start to go into a slide or go into oversteer. This car does that, not as aggressively as a Fiesta ST or even the Focus ST, but it still does that. It gives you that feeling of balance, like it just wants to dart its nose in through the corners. I really, really like that aspect of it. So when you get into the corner, you get on the throttle, it has a helical limited slip differential, so you actually are getting the power down coming out. You will understeer wide if you get on the power too early in a car like this, and this one is exactly the same way, and it does that. Unfortunately, yes, so it's front-wheel drive, you can't get around that, you have to be patient with the throttle coming out of a fast corner. But it still has that fun, a kind of excited nature going into the corner. It's not something that I can't really describe it to you, and you've had a chance to drive a good front-wheel drive car. It kind of just dances into the corner, it darts in. I would be really happy to autocross this car. I would have a really good time just kind of going around the cones and kind of going around really tight stuff. It's a fun little car. I feel like it probably could have had a little bit more horsepower. I think they maybe could have done 230 horsepower. I would have been okay with 230. Maybe 225, but 200 is a little bit low because it's a huge jump between this and the Type R. They probably did that on purpose, right? I've driven the Type R and it feels fast. It feels really fast. It's tons and tons of fun. But this car just feels a little bit less quick than you would want it to be. Yeah, so I drove this car all the way up north from where I live, and then I drove it all the way back. Almost a full tank of gas, about 600 kilometers, and I enjoyed all of it, to be perfectly honest. It's a really good car for just kind of commuting in. The seats are comfortable, they're really well bolstered, but they actually made them wide enough for a normal human, right? I'm looking at you, Focus ST. Now, what about the styling? That's really, really up to the individual. This is not the car for you if you are a, you know, business person, or you're calm, collected, and sensible. It doesn't look like that. It looks boy racer. I don't really care. It's fun. I like that it's red, the gauges are red, there's red stitching, there's red, and it says SI, everything's red. I don't know, it's just fun. I don't have any issue with that whatsoever. I've never been one to care that much what other people think about me while driving a car. I just drive the cars that I like. All right, we're on a back road, so we can kind of see a little bit more of how this car reacts to quick turn in. Watch, I'll show you how fast this car turns in. I mean, I'll try and show you. Heel toe in a second. Yeah, there we go. Good. Traction control on or traction control off. It does rotate on corner entry. Backup camera's good. It also has a blind spot camera, so when I put my right turn signal on, the camera on the rearview mirror looks where I would normally look. I don't trust it though. I still always look anyway. And I can turn that camera on and off with a button somewhere on the dashboard. I don't remember where it is. Yeah, I literally can't remember where it is. So there's a button somewhere that I can push it can turn that camera on, like when I'm in, like on the highway or something, and it can show me what's there. Right. So I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, like and subscribe. Make sure you look out for Addy Desai's review on doubleclutch.ca. He will probably disagree with me on a few points, and you can see what he has to say about the car. But if you did like this review, please subscribe, and there'll be more stuff like this coming for you. I have the Type R versus Focus RS versus STI review for One Track Mind coming out very soon on the track. So you're going to want to watch that one because the results are a little bit different than you would think. So, until then, thanks for watching.